Good afternoon. Today's video is about the Zappiti Mini 4K Media Player, or rather their technology called Magic Pixel 2.5. Yes, this technology even has versions, now they are using version 3.0. What does it represent according to the developers? Let's see what the developer Zappiti writes about it on his website. That is, we are assured that this super technology will allow you to throw away your expensive video processor and enjoy a great image with accurate colors, better contrast and quality dinterless, better upscaling and even better image when watching HDR video on fold screens. It is assumed that this media player also has a very high quality HDR to SDR converter. This statement sounds promising. Let's check if it is true. Whether this technology is really a technology, but not the beautiful nonsense of marketers. We will be testing Zappiti Mini 4K Media Player on RTD1295. This is an outdated chip, it does not support Dolby Vision. But we will be able to check the technology itself with it. To conduct a fair test, we will compare this media player with its competitor on the same chip Zidu X9s. And a cheap TV box Yugu's X2 Cube on Amlogic S905 X2 processor with disabled noise reduction. X2 Cube will be a reference device. Why it will be the image reference device? You can read about it in my other videos, but in short, this media player produces the most accurate picture quality in HDR and on par with the best media player's picture quality in full SDR. Its only Achilles heel is upscaling. How we will test it? As in past videos, we will use the Decklink Mini Recorder 4K capture card for accurate measurements and comparisons. This card is professional and allows capturing in uncompressed video format with 422 10-bit subsampling and maximum resolution of 4K 30Hz and full 60Hz. As Zappiti refused to work with this card directly as it tried to enable 4K 60Hz mode, but the capture card supports maximum 30Hz at 4K. So the capture was done through an intermediate device called Fury Integral 2. On it, the editing prohibited modes higher than 30p. Who does not know about the capture card? It allows you to transfer the image to the file with bit accuracy. The accuracy of HDMI output measurement is certainly better than you can get by measuring the characteristics of your media players by connecting them to the TV and using, for example, a calorimeter or a camera. Here is what the wiring diagram looks like. The capture was done in 422 10-bit mode to an uncompressed file in the V210 codec. Why 422 and not 444 subsampling? First, the capture card doesn't allow you to capture in 444, and second, your TV has the same 422 subsampling on the HDMI input in YCBCR mode when you connect a media player to watch video. You can only get 444 on your TV if you switch the HDMI input to PC mode. This mode disables almost all video processing on your TV, so you do not use your TV in this mode to watch video. You need this mode when you use your TV as a monitor, when you want to see small text without color outlines. So 422 mode is more than enough for comparison and verification. Captured video from Zidu and Zappiti was made by my friend from Hungary. His name is Gaber, nickname on apps from DJNICE77. Thanks him for the help in preparing this video. Capture for X2 Cube was made by me, on the same capture card, the same utility and the same output settings in the file. On the Zappiti and Zidu I set the mode 444 10-bit. This mode is the highest quality for Realtek, only in this mode Realtek is able to output 10 bits. At the same time, the X2 Cube had the 422 12-bit mode as the highest quality, although in fact the signal is still output at 10 bits. Amlogic does not support 444 subsampling, although you can set 12 bits in the menu. I will make a separate video about the difference between subsampling 444 and 422, but I can say that the difference is very insignificant, i.e. it can be neglected for this test. The analysis was done in DaVinci Resolve 17 software. This program allows us to analyze and see the smallest differences between the images, even those that are physically impossible to see with the eyes on your TV, even calibrated. From this program I made screenshots to compare exactly the pictures themselves, because in DaVinci we will analyze graphs. They will show much more useful information for analysis and comparison. I developed the methodology using the capture card and analysis in DaVinci Resolve myself, based on quite a long experience and experiments with different variants of analysis. At the moment this can be said to be a unique technology of image quality testing for devices with HDMI output. At least I have not seen videos on YouTube or on the internet where the study and analysis of the image with the same or even more accurate analysis tools. Well, let's start analyzing the results. I have compiled all the graphs at once in Paint.net in advance, just like in my previous videos, to make it easier to switch and analyze quickly. As before, I argue that the media player is not supposed to make any changes to the image. The job of the media player is to decode and output to the HDMI output an image corresponding to the original file, without additional processing, color correction, sharpening, etc. The media player is a transport that should deliver the image from the original file to the HDMI output. The media player should not try to make the image prettier, richer, or clearer than it is in the source file. All other processing, if necessary, should be done on the TV. Ideally, you should see the picture on your TV the way the director wanted to show it to us, with no additional embellishment. First test. Outputting the image in HDR. From the already known Spears and Munsell test video with the PQ4000. Here is the media info of the source file. Let's analyze it together. Now on the screen are graphics of the original video file opened in DaVinci Resolve. Zappiti has non-zero values in the default image settings and the recommended settings from the developers themselves. Here they are. So we have three screenshots of the graphs for Zappiti that we captured in this test. The first option is the Zappiti with default settings, brightness equals plus 1 and contrast equals minus 1, the second option with everything set to 0. And the third option is set by I to match the Zidu image. With these parameters, the only difference from the factory settings is the saturation parameter. This is the setting that was used to capture the third version of the image output. Zidu and X2 performed with the default settings. Let's take a look at what we got. I will switch between the images and you can see the difference visually. Let's see. This is the original. This is the all in zero mode. Next is Zappiti with the factory settings. Both of these modes give the wrong picture, the colors are distorted, they are oversaturated, and in addition all the hues are wrong, you see they are turned clockwise on the vectorscope, red becomes more crimson, etc. But the mode with saturation minus 3 outputs a picture close to what the Zidu shows, both are closer to the original than the factory mode. Look, this is Zappiti with saturation minus 3 and this is Zidu. And the X2 cube shows an almost identical picture to the original. Let's look at the pictures to see what's wrong with the images. I cut out fragments at 100% scale to show the differences. Look, this is the original and this is a fragment with the settings all to zero. See the blue gradient in steps, not smooth, also draws attention to the quality of processing of high frequency elements. Look at the diagonal lines, they are not smooth as they should be. The picture looks wrong, different from the original in saturation and brightness. The second version of the output, this is with the factory settings, the situation does not improve much, there are slight changes in the visibility of the blue gradient steps and slightly different brightness. But also far from the original. The third option with saturation minus 3, we see that colors and brightness come back to normal, now the picture is closer to the original, but the stepped gradient still remains and is clearly visible. Now let's look at the Zidu, it produces identical to the third Zappiti variant, but there is no defect with the gradient, it's smooth as it should be. The X2 cube produces a reference picture, indistinguishable from the original. Now let's look at the second defect, which can be seen at the bottom of the image. Compare, this is the original. And this is Zappiti in all zero mode. Note the squares in the YCBCR clipping test have disappeared, as well as a few squares in color space conversion. Let's switch to the factory settings. The situation has not improved. Now we switch to saturation mode minus 3. This is progress, we have seen a couple of squares in the color space conversion test. But the clipping test will fail. The squares did not appear. Also pay attention to the red bar, the visible square in the center has disappeared, and the brightness is back to normal. Now look at how Zidu worked, everything is there, the result is definitely better. By the way, the problem with clipping and gradients seems to be hereditary disease of all Realtek's chips when rendering in HDR, because the 1619DR chip has the same problem with HDR, so they also have to look for workarounds to get the right image. This means that Zidu developers were able to solve the problem, but Zappiti couldn't. The X2 cube as we can see has also succeeded, additionally the high frequency elements are brought out perfectly. Next test, this is a real photo in RAW encoded in HDR video with the peak U1000. Zappiti with the factory settings produces an image with increased saturation. Look at the vector scope, there is a slight shift of the color triangle axis clockwise, but it is not noticeable because of the greatly increased saturation. But if we turn on the second output mode with saturation -3, we see that the saturation came back to normal, but there is a slight clockwise turn of the hues. It is hardly visible to the eye, so in general you cannot worry. Zidu gives almost indistinguishable from the original image, as well as the X2 cube. Next test. Upscale from full to 4K. Here is the original picture. This is a video with a static image. Let's take a look at the graphs. In factory settings mode, Zappiti gives too saturated picture, like an HDR test. Switching to saturation mode -3 gives more correct image compared to original, but like an HDR test, color balance is slightly distorted. Zidu and X2 cube show about identical picture without color distortion. Now let's look at the clarity and sharpness of the image after upscaling. I cut and placed fragments with 100% scale on the same image, so it's easier to compare. I also added an upscale made by Shield TV Pro 2019 in upscale mode, advanced for reference. As we can see, Zappiti, Zidu and Shield produce identical images in terms of clarity and detail. For example, let's compare the images pixel by pixel, with Zappiti saturation -3 and Zidu, excluding the alpha channel, the image is identical. No magic with Zappiti upscale. If we look at the full Zappiti image with the factory settings, it turns out that Zappiti made the colors too saturated, made the image too warm. Next test. Dinterless. We see that dinterlessing works 100% identically, the image is the same. Once again it turns out that the developers of Zappiti forgot to add magic pixels. Next we test the full image output natively in 1080p, without upscaling. Here everything repeats, just like in the upscale test. We have a saturated image at default settings and close to the original image in saturation mode -3, but again with slightly changed color shades. If we look at the image fragments at 100% zoom, you will see that there is no difference between all the images, everything is the same. There are differences of course, but they are related to different color interpolation techniques. But with your eyes you will not see this in the real image. The only thing you can see with your eyes is a slightly oversaturated image with Zappiti in the factory settings mode. And the last test, this is the HDR to SDR conversion mode. What we see? At factory settings, the Zappiti produces a more natural and correct image after conversion to SDR. See the image. Zidu, by default, produces a less correct image. So here it is the work of magic pixel technology. We see that the Zappiti was indeed able to produce a good result and outperformed the Zidu in terms of image quality. It turns out that some technology helped the Zappiti produce a better result in this test. So the magic pixel exists and really works? No, it's not magic, it's just more accurate image adjustments when converting from HDR to SDR. Let me show you how this magic works. Take Zidu, change factory settings to this one, and get exactly the same image as in Zappiti. We can look at graphs, here is Zappiti, here is Zidu with default settings, you can see the lack of contrast and color saturation, and here is the same Zidu with manually adjusted image settings. You can see that the image became similar, and even the color triangle became more correct. The only disadvantage of this Zidu's solution is that image adjustments affect regular folder HDR output. Therefore, these settings cannot be left permanently. Let's summarize. As expected, Zappiti does not have any magic technology, and to call it a technology word is fundamentally wrong, it is a fraud on buyers. Zappiti on the factory settings on the contrary produces the wrong image, with excessive saturation of colors, yes it has the effect that we see a more beautiful image to the eye, but this image is not identical to the original. On the HDMI output from the media player we have an image that is contrary to the director's intent. Additionally, Zappiti failed to solve the clipping issue and the problematic gradient in the Realtek chip. The only thing Zappiti developers can be proud of is that they picked up more correct settings for the conversion from HDR to SDR and made these settings independent. But, the same effect we can achieve on Zidu, but we will have to change these settings for conversion from HDR to SDR every time, because these settings affect all variants of image output. After I had already done an analysis of all the tests, Gaber decompiled the Zappiti firmware and found out where the slightly wrong shades came from, which I found from the graphs. It turned out that the Zappiti developers had tweaked the shades in addition to saturation. As a result, to get a 100% correct image, you need to set hue equals minus 2 in the image settings for Zappiti. Here is a comparison with these settings for the HDR and upscale test. As you can see, with these settings saturation equals minus 3 and hue equals minus 2, the image is as close as possible to the image produced by the Zidu and the reference X2 cube. So these are the parameters you need to set on your Zappiti to fix the image which was ruined by the Zappiti developers with their bad hands. I hope I was able to show and prove to you that there is no magic pixel technology, it's just crooked image settings that make the image not match the reference image that the media player is supposed to produce. If the developers of Zappiti have an objection or claim and can prove that there is indeed some technology, but I could not find it, then I am ready to discuss, but only with evidence. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, peace and goodness to all. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel, I will try to do more videos in English. Thanks again to my friend DJNICE77 from avsfrom.com, who helped in preparing the material for this video.